Hi everyone, for this week lab, we're going to be working on Herbolov's law. And as you can see from the slide right here, Herbolov's law basically indicated that the universe is expanding. One of the reasons why it's so is because when Herbolov did his experiment, you notice that, let me zoom in a little bit. You notice that he was looking at galaxy near our Milky Way galaxy, and this x direction right here measures the distance to the galaxy, and this y axis right here measure the velocity of that galaxy. And he noticed that the galaxy that is further away from Earth is also moving faster away from Earth right here, right? You can see that the further it is away, the faster it's moving away. So it seemed like everything is moving away from us right there. The correct interpretation is that space in itself is expanding. So if space in itself is expanding, you can see an analogy of the lump of raisin right here, right? The dough is rising. So if the dough is the universe right here and it's expanding, the bread is the dough is rising, then and each one of the raisin right here is a galaxy. And no matter where you are located, when you look around, you see that thing is moving away. And if, like for example, if this guy right here is far away, then compared like to, for example, there's another galaxy right here, then because space in between expanding, this guy is going to be looking at to be moving away faster. So when Herbolov looking around to see that the galaxy is expanding, to see that the galaxy is moving faster the farther it's away, the correct interpretation is that the universe is expanding. Now if it's expanding at this, you know, at a certain rate, right, then 1 billion years ago, the universe was closer. 2 billion years ago, it was closer and closer and closer right there, right? So when we work out, for example, the rate of the expansion of the universe from this data point right here, we're gonna do is that we're gonna look at the data, and then we're gonna fit a straight line through that data that best fit the data right there, right? And from this slope right here, we can get the Herbolov constant. Okay, this Herbolov constant right here, if you inverted it, it's gonna give you the time or the age of the universe. And the best estimated right now is 13.7, about 14 billion years right there. When Herbolov did it, back in the turn of the last century, it was not, the instrument is not as advanced as it is right now. So his result is a little bit up right there. And it wasn't until maybe the 60s or so when we start having better instrumentation, so we can start getting better and better numbers. So for this week lab, we're gonna be doing the Herbolov law. Okay, now in your assignment, there is the link right here. When you click on that, it's gonna take us to my Colab notebook. Okay, let me move it down right here. Okay. And you can see right there, I already put in the data for us. So all you have to do is basically just Control A. You start a new notebook. Give me 1 second. Let's do this. Let's start a new notebook, for example, right there. Okay. And then just copy, okay, Control A, highlight, Control A, Control C. On a Mac, it's gonna be Command A or Command C. So right here, right, just paste it. You can do Control V to paste it over and run it, okay? And it's gonna take a while for me to do that. And you might also want to double click right here to change the title. Maybe lab, what lab is it, 14, Herbolov, for example, right there. Okay, and then on the next one, You're gonna want to copy. This is right here is a list. I create a list of distance and list of velocity. Okay, you just highlight that and press Control C or copy selection right there. You can do that also. Okay, and then bring over here and make sure that you create this one right here also a code cell, and then create another code cell right there. For example, if I hit delete that, if I type in shift and enter, it's gonna execute this code for me and bring it to the next one. If you don't have that, for example, you can just create a code cell from here and then type in control V, okay? And hit either hit shift enter, shift the key with enter together, okay? Or just go here and run it, okay? And we have a distance list and velocity list right here. Where do I get this list from? If you go to our, give me 1 second, right? If you go out to our homepage, okay? You will see that this link right here, there's the PDF file. There's a PDF file, there's a zip file containing PDF lab. If you download that, you're gonna see that there's a lab called Hubble Constant right there, okay? And that's where I'm basing this lab on, okay? And from I'm getting it from that right one right there. So let me click out of that. Now, if you open that lab hubbleconstant.pdf, you would see the instruction right here. You notice that how time and technology has changed, right? When I first started teaching astronomy, basically this is a lab I was given, you know, at the turn of the last century right there. And you notice that everything was done kept like maybe paper and pencil, for example, right now, right there. And the distance list, let me go back right here, right? The distance list, I'm basically getting it from this one right here, 11.0, 40, 40, 50, 58, right? 11, 0, 40, 50, 50, 58. So I'm basically just going down this list right here, and I'm only gonna get the data where you have both X and Y, distance and velocity. In our situation right here, distance is gonna be on the X axis, and velocity is gonna be on the Y axis. So I'm only gonna get the data point that have both X and Y, X and Y, and X and Y, X and Y letters right here. Like for example, Ursa Major, I would skip that, I wouldn't use that one right now because it has incomplete information. We not able to use that to extrapolate or to put a fitting data to that right there, okay? So, and for the Y, you can see, right, 1500, 3800, 5000, okay? So 38, 5048, right? So I'm just basically filling this list from our lab right there, okay? One thing you also want to do when you do it on your own for the next part is that you're gonna want to have a number of distant element in the distant list and the velocity list to be the same, right? Let me count right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Right? So you want to have it the same matching number, because if you make a typo and miss one or two writers right here, right? When we go to plot it later on, it's going to give you an error because, you know, it has to be one by one correspondent right there. Okay. So when we have this, when we have this list, getting from this data right here, the next thing we're gonna do is that we're gonna do a scatter plot. This will be familiar to us right now using matplotlib, okay? Import matplotlib right here. So we're just gonna highlight that, Control C, and put in Control V, like this right here, okay? And run that. You see that it's gonna plot our velocity distance versus velocity for us, right? And here is an X label, here's a Y label, here is the title right there, and the fixed size, you know, I set it 10 by 10 right there, okay? So here's a Hubble law. Now, when we have this right here, right, we want to fit a line, a linear line through this data point right here. And the way to do that is that we're going to have to rely on NumPy. It's not a library packet that we can import into Colab to use it, right? And NumPy is a library for programming language. It adds support for large multi-dimensional array matrix and large collection of high-level mathematical function to operate on this array. So it's a mathematical library that we can import in to use it to, for example, in our situation to find a linear fit right there, okay? And then you can see right there, right? If you go to the next line, hit Control C, and then add a new code, okay? And Control V, and you do a fit. Okay, this one's saying that it's, you know, it's a polynomial fit, right? And the order is first order, okay? Which is linear. For example, if it's, you have second, then it's square, it would be quadratic. And what do we want to fit? We want to fit distance and velocity, which is this one right here. And you know, the distance and velocity is a variable that I just name it ourselves right there, okay? You can name your variable in any way you want, but you want to be descriptive as much as possible. So when they look at this right here, they know that people would know that I'm talking about the distance, and this one right here, I'm talking about velocity, okay? So if you do a Hubble fit, right, you do a linear fit, and you want to output your result into this variable. Again, right, this one right here, I can name it. You know, in Python, variable, it just, you know, is something that you can think of as a container to store your result, to store something, right? And you're gonna want to name your container as appropriate as possible so that people who can know. So they will look at this, people look at this, they will say that, I'm talking about the Hubble fit, okay? And this one right here just output the result. So you notice that here it's gonna give us the slope. The slope is basically rise over run, right? So imagine here's a linear line, and you have the rise over run, right? So that's the slope of the line. And this one right here is the intersection point. It means that if x equal to zero, if distance equal to zero, okay, what would y be? Yeah, you notice that it's pretty close to zero in this situation right there, okay? So we have our slope. And this one right here is the Hubble constant right here. Okay, this one right here is the Hubble constant where you can invert it to get the age of the universe, okay? So go back to this one right here. We're gonna want to plot this line onto our plot before. So when you copy over, right, you don't have to copy the node that I have right here. Just do the code, that'd be good enough, okay? And so you're gonna want to have, click on the next code, put it in here. So I'm basically plotting, see right here, right? I'm basically plotting the same thing as before, but now I also want to add in the line right here. Okay, so I'm adding this line right here. I want us to plot the line. And then here is the, let me print it out so that I can show us to us right here, okay? And then this one right here, just I want to put some text, to give us some context into the plot right here, okay? So here is the equation, velocity equal to 107 minus 50. So this text area, and I'm placing it at this location right here. Yeah, I could place it at somewhere over here. Let me change it right here, okay? 500, and do that, see what happened. And let's put it right here, right? So let me change it back to 250 and hit it and run it. You see that, you know, this one right here is this equation. You see that it's a fitting equation, the slope and the y-intercept, which I got it from right here, okay? Now, so here is your equation, okay? The next thing you're gonna do, we're gonna do is, you notice that this one right here is slightly different. Okay, so double click on this Okay, double click on this. You notice that this one right here is a text entry, not a code entry. So you're going to want to, what you're going to want to do is highlight the whole thing, hit Control C, and bring it over here. Okay, bring it over here and create a new text cell. Okay, and then you're going to paste that over with Control V or Command V on the Mac right there. Okay, and these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 row is essentially, one second, the missing row in here. See right there, right? Ursa Major 80, Centaurus 150, and missing Y. Okay, so give me one second. So here is Ursa Major 80 with the missing one, and the Pegasus 2 is, give me one second, Pegasus 2, right, 12,000, it has a Y, but it's missing X. So some, you know, some in here has X, but missing Y. Some in here has Y, but missing X. So that's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them right there, okay? So what you're gonna do is that, again, let me repeat this stage right here, okay? So when you figure out the plot right here, the line right here, okay? When you figure out the line right here, okay? The next thing you're gonna do is, one of the next things you're gonna do is copy this, click on this, okay? Again, click on this. Copy, highlight it, Control C or Command C, bring it over. Okay. So assuming that I didn't have this one right here, okay, and let me delete that, right? So bring it over, but this time create a text entry. So in the text entry, you're gonna paste this thing over. So it's gonna create, you know, this is how you create a table. So right here, I create a 3x5 table with the, basically the row that has missing X or Y, missing D or V right here, right? So Omega, missing V. So I would go, you see right there, right? Ursa Major, Pegasus, missing X right there, right? Pegasus, missing X right there. So this, for this part of the lab right here, right? What I want us to do is I want us to use this formula, because this right here is our, you know, we fit the line, the linear line to this data right here, right? And we have this equation right here. So I want us to use this equation to find the missing X or Y. So like for example, if you have Ursa Major, you have missing V right there, right? And you know that it has a distance of 80. So you put 80 in here and you solve it and you get velocity. So if, for example, if Hydra have missing velocity but missing distance, and you put 60,000 in here and you solve for distance and you put it in here. And the way to do that is, like for example, you go back here, X, Y, Z, for example, you do that. You notice that it's gonna enter in here. Right? You wanna go back to this, double click on this, and then change it to, for example, A, B, C, okay? And this is how you generate the Markdown table. The way I do that, I basically just go to this website right here, table generator, for example, right? And then I click on generate, and then the column right there, right? Table set size. I can do, like, for example, 3x5. I can do like 5x7 table. I can do like 9x5, for example, I set that. And then I generate it, stay right there, right? I just copy it to the clipboard and bring them over to Colab. But make sure that you create a text entry for this part right here, okay? Let's come back to the other one right there, right? Which is question number 4, calculate the age of the universe right there. So if we know that the Hubble constant is from our fitting 107.8, then the age of the universe is basically just the inverse of that from our PowerPoint right here, okay? So what we're going to do is for that, we're just going to create a new code. Okay, right there. And hit, you know, hit enter. So that could be the age of the universe. Okay. But if you want to print it out, right? Print age of universe. It give us 0.0092, which we know is not the answer right there. I mean, my, well, I think I'm still young, right? But, you know, I my age is still much bigger than this one right here. The reason why is the unit is not correct, right? So if you want to have converted to year, right? Then you need to copy this line right here, okay? Bring it over. And have another entry. You can see right there, right? This one right here, we converted, use its conversion factor, and we converted to the age of the universe in year, which is about 9.7 billion, 9.07, 9.1 billion years. It's still pretty low, right? Because the exact number of the age of, of our universe is about 13.7 billion years right here. And as I mentioned that when Herbert was working at the turn of last century, right? He didn't have good instrumentation. So his estimate was off by a little bit because some of the star, some of the cluster, some of the object in our Milky Way galaxy is older than that, than his estimate. And you cannot have Chai, you know, which is a galaxy in our universe, be older than its parent, which is a universe right there. So his estimate is a little bit up. Now, so for this part of the lab right there, right, what you're gonna, you know, the first thing you're gonna do is just follow, copy and paste this code right here to run the linear fit and to find the age of the universe according to our data, the old data right here in our lab, okay? And then the next one you're gonna do is that you're gonna use this formula that we found, right? This line right here that we found, 107 minus 50, to, you know, to fill in the blank. If you miss X, solve for X. If you miss Y, solve for Y, okay? And the way to fill in the blank is just double click on this. Let me get out of that. Double click on this. And then just go in here and just fill in, like, for example, 13.5 or something like that. You can see right there, right? It would work, okay? Then the final part is this right here. This is a newer, data that we got, okay? So you, what you're gonna do is that you're gonna create a new, same thing, you know, just go all the way from the beginning, copy this. And here, create a code, okay? Create a code cell and just delete all of this. Okay, and then, you know, create your new list of distance and velocity based on the new data. For example, 2, 9.16, 16.4, right? So you have 2, 9.16, 0.16, and then 16.4, okay? And so on, right? You just keep on, you know, doing that until the end right there. It's not that much. And then for the Y, you're gonna do the same thing, 133, 644, 664, 664, and then 1794. And like that right there, right? You wanna make sure that it has the same matching number right there, right? Because if you miss one or two and it doesn't have a matching, had an equal length at the end, it can throw you an error because there's a typo somewhere. So make sure that, you know, whatever number of data for D and V is super matching. So when you do this right here, right, just go back here and copy and paste this down here and run the same thing again, right? You should be able, to get maybe a better number of the estimate of the age of the universe than this 9.07 billion right there, okay? And so basically that's the gist of this lab right here. Now, if you are not comfortable with Colab right there, right? You can do this on a piece of paper, take a pictures, and you know, and turn it in, right? Don't leave it blank, because if you leave it, the assignment blank, I cannot give you partial credit right there, right? So if I've seen that you try something, then I can give you partial credit, okay? And so you can do the same thing. For example, if you look at this right here, right, 41,380. So you can go down, you print it out right here, you go to 41,380 is 300, right? 246, so 380 is right here, and 41,000 somewhere, maybe right over here, right? You make a dot right there, and you keep on doing that, right? And you can draw a line, and you can do a rise over run, and you can get the estimate, you can get the same number, like this one right here, similar number, closing up right there, right? And you can use this conversion factor right here to estimate the age of a universe in years. Okay, so you can certainly do this by hand, right? So once you have that formula, you can come back and fill in this missing information as I explained right there, and take pictures of that and turn it in. So that way right there, you can get more credit than just, you know, skip this part altogether. All right, so let me stop the, right there, let me stop the recording now, and